job, but are your hips square?
What do you mean? I'm sitting in a split. I'm sitting on the floor, so why does that matter?
Oh dear, I have lots to teach you. Hi, it's Elena, and today we're gonna talk about square splits. So there are actually two ways of doing a split, and the first one is what Ellie just showed you. See how her hips are open and heels facing to the side? That's what I call twisted hips. The second one, and the one that I recommend, is called square splits. Why square splits? It doesn't matter, right? The main reason for me is to keep myself from getting injured.
Okay, so I explained this terribly in the video, so I'm gonna say it again. When you do splits and you do an arch, if you're twisted, then you're gonna twist like diagonally, which isn't really good for your back because you're only using one side. So if you keep your square hips and your arch, you're using both sides of your back the same amount, so then you won't get as injured as you would if you're twisting. I hope that makes sense. I don't even know. Anyways, yeah, it's just to help you not get injured as much when you're growing older, because when you're younger, then it's way easy to just use your back and do whatever you want. As you get older, there's more pressure on your back and you're having more difficult elements, rhythmic gymnasts especially. So yeah, that's why I recommend square splits. But if you're in ballet or anything and your teacher tells you to do like open hips, then that's totally fine. I'm just recommending what I do and what I've learned.
Wait, so how do I know if my hips are square? Great question, Ellie, I'll show you. If you're home or have space, then you can join along. First, I'm gonna grab a stick or a club for rhythmic gymnast, and we're gonna put it towards our hips. Now I'm gonna have my good leg out, and we're gonna have our stick onto our hips. And now we're gonna slowly go down. Elena, like this? No, see how your club's twisted like this? Oh, okay, so I have to, oof. Okay, I think I'm in square hips now, but it kinda hurts and I can't go down anymore. Looking good, Ellie. Now if you start feeling a stretching pain, that's good. You just have to drop your clubs there and start stretching right there. Okay, so put my club down and stretch right there. Good job. Now, you can also check if you have square hips by keeping your knee on the floor and your heels facing the ceiling like this. Now, make sure you guys are keeping your hips square like me and Ellie. If you're sitting on the floor, then you can try to also cross over like this with your left hand on your right knee and your right hand on your back left knee. Another way to check is to make sure when you bend your knee, your toes are facing up and not diagonal. If you're learning square hips, if it's too hard to go down or your hands can't touch the floor, then you can also get blocks or anything that can keep your posture straight. So you can also push down like this instead of leaning your body forward. If this helps, it's fine too. But I recommend keeping your body straight. If you try to do square splits and you're right here, don't fret, I started like this when I was 10. But every single day, I would stretch slowly and slowly until I made it into a split and nice and square. And we should stretch every day so we can get better and better.
That's the spirit, let's keep stretching.
Elena, you can sit in a square split. So how do you check if you're in a square split for over splits?
So once you sit on the floor and get into over splits, I recommend using a ball. Any ball will do.
If I can sit in an over split with my ball, I can try to sit down, but if I can't, I can also stretch here with square hips. If I can touch on the floor, I can raise my arms up and balance.
If you have to adjust or if your leg falls off, we're gonna have to work on that. Don't worry though, it's a learning experience.
Yeah, even doing normal splits confuses me on the floor, so I always have to recheck. And that's totally okay, we just have to put in our effort.
Okay, next, if you were able to stay stable with the ball in the front, it's time to get the ball under your back knee. If you can't go down, it's okay too. Stretch there.
Now if you're super advanced, you can try two balls. Same thing here. You're gonna have your front ball on your front leg, back on your back knee, and you're gonna sit. Watch if I'm twisted. I'm gonna fall. If I'm staying square, I wouldn't have to worry about falling. Ta-da!
If you did it without falling with two balls, big congrats to you. You have perfect square splits.
Okay, now the dreadful part. Other side. Oh no, the other leg. I don't like my other leg. Yeah, I don't like doing my back side either, but we gotta do it.
I know. Let's go do it.
For the left side, I'm gonna be fast forwarding this, but you guys can go back and watch so you can work together. All right, we you did it. I'm done. No more splits today. Yay. If you learned something or liked the video, please go on and hit that like button. Yeah, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. And comment down below any questions you guys have about square splits or anything, and also what you guys want to see more on my channel. I'll be trying to post almost every week, so next one will be a splits tutorial. Thank you, bye. I'll try more splits next time. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you next time. Bye. Hi, yay! Mama ka bigin bigin at the doctor at the gin. If you're super advanced, you can try two goals. Oh my god. If you learned something or like the video, please like the subscribe button. Okay. Time for me to take a nap.